In the name of Jesus. God bless you, real good. God bless you, real good. Thanks for joining. Thanks for joining. God bless you. God bless you. May God uplift you. May God promote you all in the name of Jesus. What a glorious day we have. What an awesome service today. It's going to be great. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be wonderful today. God is going to bless you. He's going to transform somebody here today in the name of Jesus. Lord, we appreciate your holy name. We give you praise. Karabo shakatala bayagadish.
Awesome.
That's it. Awesome God all the way.
There is no one like you. Around the world, I found no one like you. Oh, she made me a the lintel of my head. I don't never do that. You are the mighty man. Of my life, oh, is it? You are the one I trust. You are the one I look for. You are the savior of my soul. She miria tata,
you found a never of life. You live forevermore.
Oh yes.
Oh, shit.
and trust on you. I will love you, love you, love you as you love me.
As you keep
me. Oh, yes.
As you trust me.
Mm-hmm.
As you help me. As you heal me. As you bless me.
Make up a shelter.
As you lead me, Jesus.
Oh. Glory, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. May your name be praised. May your name be glorified. What a glorious day we have. What a wonderful day. God is going to bless you today, whether the devil likes it or not. There is going to be a supernatural upliftment in your lives, divine turnaround in your life, in your destinies today, in the name of Jesus. God is going to bless you. He's going to touch you, strong touch. No powers can hold you down. Demons cannot hold you down. Because you are a successful child. You are born to win. You are born to reign. You are born to take dominion. Rabba Shakata Labayagadesha. Lord, we thank you, 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 we thank you. We bless your holy name. Reke was going to Braka Kotala Bayagadesh, Iko Kotola Bayagadesh. They won't be Yama song, Yama words, Yama language. It's enough, fade away. Excuse me, 1 second. I'm joining you. For that short break. God, let me lower down the music. Hallelujah to Jesus. Glory, 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 glory be to God. You all are welcome once again today to the presence of God. You are welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. You are welcome to today's service in the name of Jesus. I celebrate every one of you here today, as many that is viewing me now, and as many that will view me later. I celebrate every one of you today in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Glory. I celebrate every one of you today in the mighty name of Jesus. You are welcome, you are welcome. You are welcome, you are welcome. The reason why you came here today, may God settle you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah to Jesus. Let us begin to pray. Father, Lord, we bless you. We give you praise, we give you glory. We give you honor, all adoration. I thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity, Lord, to gather here again in your presence. Lord, we say we magnify your name in Jesus' name. Lord, I surrender. Holy Ghost is all about you. Do your work today and take the glory for yourself in Jesus' name. I pray, Lord, that your word that you are going to speak today, let it fall on the good ground in the hearts of your people. Let it fall on the good ground in their hearts to bless them, to heal them, to deliver them, to transform them. In the mighty name of Jesus, help your people not to be hearers alone, to deceive themselves, that they may hear and walk according to your word in Jesus' name. I thank you, Holy Spirit, because you are here. I thank you because it is settled. May your name be glorified in the name of Jesus. Every spirit that is not of God, I arrest your powers right now. I bring you under submission now in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Please, as you are joining us, do well to share. Do well to share the video. Hallelujah. Some of you have not really shared. You know I'm on my page. This page, they tell me everything where they go on here. Hallelujah. So please do well to share. Share, share, share to your friends. Invite your loved ones and let them come and join us today. Don't be blessed alone. Don't be blessed alone. Don't be blessed alone. Let somebody be part of today's blessings. Let your friends join. Let your families join. Let your loved ones come and be part of these blessings today. And God will surely settle you by doing that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah to Jesus. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jehovah Nissi. I celebrate every one of you here today. I can see you. I welcome you today to today's service. I welcome you, great woman of God. I celebrate you. I celebrate all the men and women of God in the house today. I appreciate every one of you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Please, if you have not shared the video, do well to share. Like the page and share. Glory be to God. Like the page and share. If you have not liked the page, if you are not following yet, click on it. It will give you a sign where you can follow the page. And a sign where you can click on the bell for all notification, so that whenever we come online, you will be the first to see the notice. And God will surely bless you as you do so in Jesus' precious and wonderful name. Thank you, Jehovah Nissi. So please, my beloved brothers and sisters, as you are joining us today, you are not coming here in vain. Your coming here is because God wants to do something in your life. I really want to talk on this very wonderful topic today. Hallelujah. What I've entitled, Tools for Change in the Body of Christ. Tools for Change. Tools for Change in the Body of Christ. In the Body of Christ. Hallelujah. Like we were meant to know that the Body of Christ is every one of us. We are the Body of Christ. There are things, there are weapons of change. There are tools of change. There are things that we need that can transform us, that can help us to be transformed in our Christianity. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I like us to understand today that no matter how good you are as a child of God, no matter how faithful you are, no matter how wonderful you are, no matter how awesome you are, no matter how blessed you think you are, no matter how kind you are to people, no matter how, I don't know the right word to use again, that you think you are, no matter the saints, the angel that you think you are, no matter the holiness that you think you are practicing, you must offend somebody one day, and somebody else must also offend you. The tools of change that I want to talk about here in the bodies of Christ, it has to do with offenses, bitterness, anger and unforgiveness. These are the tools for change in the body of Christ. I want to talk about offenses, anger, bitterness in the body of Christ. Glory be to God. That is why I told us that no matter how good you think you are, no matter how kind you think you are, no matter how awesome you think you are, no matter the saint, the angel that you think you are, offenses must come. Offenses must come. It's either you offend somebody or somebody else offends you. So we must take note that this thing must happen in our lives. Why? Because no matter how careful you think you are, there are things you do that in your sight it is right, but to the hearer it is an offense. You might think you are doing good. You might think what you are telling the person is the right word. You might think you are living right with a man, with a woman. But that person you are speaking to might not see things from your own perspective. They might not see things the way you see it. They might not understand things the way you understand them. So because of that, they feel offended by your own words. They feel offended by what you say. They feel offended by what you do. The same thing applies to you. Somebody can be talking to you rightfully. To the mind of the person is right, and to you that is hearing, you might pick offense from the person's word. So it is a certainty that offenses must come. So offense is not something we can do away with. It's not something that we'll pray against. It's not something that cannot come to pass or that cannot happen in the life of an individual. Glory be to God. The ability to overcome it, the ability to do away with it is what matters. Or how to handle the offenses is also another thing that matters a lot in our lives as a body of Christ. As a body of Christ, we were made to understand the other day that no matter how close as the tongue is to the teeth, they fight. They offend each other. That is why sometimes your teeth will bite your tongue and it still remain in the mouth. It's not cut off from the mouth. Because the teeth bite your tongue, you cannot pull your teeth out and say, "This is my teeth, you are wicked. Why did you bite my tongue?" It doesn't work like that. Glory be to God. So no matter how it is in life, offenses are things that we must expect in life and destiny. So if it comes to you, the way you handle it, the way you take it, the way you see it, is what matters in your life as a child of God. Let us quickly open our Bible to the book of Matthew. Matthew chapter 18. I'll read verse 7. We are going to be reading so many Bible verses today. I want to talk with us from the word of God, from the Bible itself. Glory be to God. Matthew chapter 18, verse 7. The Bible says, it says, "Woe unto who?" Glory be to God. Hallelujah. It says, "Woe unto the world because of what?" Offense. Because of offense. "Woe unto the world because of offense." Offenses must come, I told you. "For it must needs be that offense come." The Bible says it must needs be. It's a must. It's a must. So if the Bible is telling you that it is a must that offense must come, which means it is something that must happen. When offense comes, it doesn't mean that you are a devil or the other person is a devil. It is something that must come to pass, that must happen in the life of every individual. Glory be to God. It says offenses must come. Offenses, he said, they must, he said, they need that offenses come. He said, "But woe unto that man by whom the offense cometh." Woe to that brother, woe to that sister by whom the offense comes. That person that causes that offense, that person is already under a curse. Any man or woman bringing confusion in the body of Christ, any man or woman bringing divinity in the body of Christ, any man or woman trying to scatter the body of Christ, the Bible has already placed them. God says, "Woe unto that person." That word "woe," I see it as a curse to that man, to that woman, to that boy, to that girl, to that person, whosoever it is that is assigned to cause divinity, to cause confusion, to cause problem in the body of Christ. Glory be to God Almighty. Everybody can be offended. It is only a dead person that is not offended. Only a man in the grave that is not offended. Only a woman in the grave that cannot be offended. So long as you are on earth, So long as you are a living being, so long as you are a human being, you must know one day that offenses will come. The ability to handle it is what matters in life. Offenses must come. It must come. It is a must. It's something that must happen. It is not something that you can escape. Bible says it must. So if the word of God says it must, it's something that you should wait for. It is something that you should expect. So when offense comes, my brothers and sisters, you can be offended. The ability to handle offense is what matters in your life as an individual. The ability to handle offense is what matters in your life as a brother, as a sister. Glory be to God Almighty. Offenses must come. Glory, glory, glory. If you look the book of Matthew, the same Mark, the book of Mark, let us quickly go there. I'm told that we are going to be picking from the word of God today. The book of Mark chapter 11. Hallelujah. The book of Mark 11. I'll read from verse 25. So 26, he said, when you stand praying, whenever you stand praying, he said, forgive. The Bible says, when you stand praying, he said, forgive. Please share this video. So many of you have not shared. Please share the video. Thanks to those of you that have shared. Hallelujah. Sister Agatha, you have not shared. So many of you, we have not shared. Please do well to share the video. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. He said, offenses must come. Amen, somebody. He said, but hallelujah, I'm reading from 11:25. He said, and when you stand praying, he said, forgive. For if you have ought against anyone, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. He says, when you stand praying, he said, forgive before you pray. Before you go and pray against for God to, in anything or any area of your life, before you, as a brother, as a sister, before you go and stand and say, Father, have mercy. Oh God, I need this. Father, do this for me. Before you do that, you must first of all forgive somebody that have offended you. Because the Bible says it must need be. It must come. But how do you handle offense when it comes? You will handle it in your own way, or you handle it according to the word of God. The word of God says it will surely come. But you have to forgive. He said when you start praying, whenever you start to pray, and you remember that somebody has offended you, the word of God says forgive that person before you come and pray. God, forgive that person, so that as you forgive the person, that is when God will forgive you. He said forgive them, for the word of God I'll be giving us strictly from the Bible. Hallelujah. He said when you start praying, hallelujah, he said forgive if you have ought against any, if you hurt somebody or if somebody hurts you, that your Father which is in heaven will also forgive you your trespasses. And 26 says, but if ye do not forgive, neither will your own Father which is in heaven forgive your own trespasses. It is a Bible principle. It is a principle. If you cannot let go of a brother that offends you, if you cannot let go of a sister that offends you, God will not let go of your sin. If you cannot forgive the man, if you cannot forgive the sister because somebody did something wrong to you and you are still holding it against that person, you refuse to let go. You are holding it up. You are tying somebody in your hands. You refuse to let go. No need for you to pray. Don't pray. If I am you, don't pray. When you are praying, the Bible said the prayer of a sinner, my sin is like a filthy rag. It's like a rag. Your prayer, that prayer, you are just crying and you are praying. It's like a filthy rag. It's a sin in the sight of God. Because while you are holding somebody, the Bible says, until you let go, it said God cannot forgive you. This is the word of God. It says you don't forgive those that offend you, their trespasses. It says your own heavenly Father, which is the God that created the heaven and the earth. He said, God will not forgive you your own sin. God will not forgive you your own sin. Why? Because you are holding the man. Why? Because you are holding the woman. And you are coming to God and say, Father, mercy. You can pray from January to December without letting the person go. And you are saying, God, please do this for me. You are saying, God, have your way. You are saying, Holy Ghost, do this for me. And God is saying to you, have you forgiven the brother? Have you forgiven the sister? Have you forgiven that person that offends you? And you say, no. And God will say, go and forgive. Until you forgive me, God will not forgive you. God cannot forgive. God cannot even hear your prayer. Talk less of forgiving you. If you are holding somebody in heart, if you are holding that brother, if you are holding that sister, if you refuse to forgive, don't pray. Don't pray. No need of prayer. Until you let go of that brother that you are holding in your heart, until you let go of that sister you are holding in your heart, don't come and pray to God. Our God is not a and out of confusion. Our God is a God that sees the heart of a man. He sees you deep down your heart. He knows you more than you know yourself. My brothers and sisters, before you come to God, always have it in mind, no matter the condition, no matter the situation, no matter what that brother has done to you, always learn to let go. Always learn to let go so that God will let go of your sin. So that God will let go of your sin. If you don't let go, the word of God just told me, from this book of Matthew chapter 11, 25 to 26, where we read, he said, God will not forgive you until you let go of that sin of that brother, until you let go of that sin of that sister. God will not forgive you. Offense is a trap that devil used for destruction. That trap is a trap that devil used for destruction and damnation. Offense is a trap that devil used to destroy the people of God. It's a trap that devil used to cause condemnation, to condemn a man, a woman of God. The bad devil will use offense as a tool, as a channel to penetrate the brother, as a channel to penetrate the sister. My brothers and sisters, time has come for us to let go. It doesn't matter what that person has done to you. You must let go. Not for anything, because Jesus said, let it go. Because you know that if you don't let go, God will not hear you. Talk less of answering your prayer. So if I am you, I will let go very easily. It doesn't matter what the person has done. What's your own passion, your part of the story is forgive the person. Let it go off your heart so that devil will not hold it against you. It is a tools that devil use. It is a channel that devil use to trap down Christians. It is a channel that devil use to block your prayers, not to reach God, talk less of answers. If God cannot hear you, how can God answer you? If God cannot hear your prayer, how can God answer you? My brothers and sisters, do away with offense, anger. Do away with offenses. Do away with unforgiveness until you learn to forgive. Don't waste your time to pray. Don't waste your time to pray. When you are angry, the Bible says we have right to be angry, but don't sin. He said, don't let it go down to the next day. You must let go of that brother you are holding in the heart. You must let go of that sister that you are holding in the heart so that God will let go of whatever it is that is you are passing through in your life. You have a role to play. God have a role to play. Until you place your role, God say, if you don't forgive, you say, God will not forgive you. According to where we write right now, the book of Mark chapter 11, it will not go. Hallelujah. Offenses must come. Offenses hinder your access to prayer. Offenses anger, unforgiveness, they hinder your answer to prayer. Offenses, anger, unforgiveness is offenses that cause all these things. It's offenses that cause anger, bitterness, unforgiveness. It's offenses that cause all these things. God has nothing to do with this. You have right to be angry, but Bible said, don't let it become a sin. Be angry, but don't sin. Don't let it go down you to the next day. As the body of Christ, you must learn how to let go. No matter how it looks like, no matter what you feel like, you must let go, knowing very well, not for any other thing. Number one, because you are one body. Number two, because it hinders your prayer. It blocks access to your prayer. It blocks access to your prayer. It makes your prayer to be irrelevant. It makes God not to answer your prayer. Please share this video. If you have not shared, Brother Wisdom, Sister Rachel, a lot of you have not shared the video. Please do well to share. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It blocks access to your own prayer. Offenses, anger, and bitterness. My brothers and sisters, the root of all this thing is offenses. When a man offends you, you too, you offend people. There are a lot of people that you have also offended in your life that they have let go. If you are holding people's sin against them, remember, you are not a saint, you are not an angel. You too, you offend people. You offend people in different ways. By your words, by your actions, by your thought, you offend one. You see, one way we offend all in different ways. So you too, you have offended somebody one way or the other. What if that person holds you bound in the hand? When you are holding a man, a woman in your hand, you are telling God not to forgive that person. You are blocking the person's access. You are hindering the person's prayer. The same time you are hindering your own prayer, God cannot hear you when you pray. Not because of that man, but because of you, you must let go. Not because of that woman, but because of you, you must let go. If not, as you are bonding a man, as you are tying a man, you are tying yourself down. That is why God is giving us this message. As a body of Christ that we are, we must let go that brother. We must let go that sister that we are still tying in our hands. We must let go. We must learn how to forgive one another, no matter how what the person has done, no matter how it looks like. You might understand it, you might not understand it, but because God says let go, you must let go. May God give you the heart, forgiveness in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Offenses hinder answers to prayer. The Bible says when you start to pray, he says forgive. When you start to pray, forgive, let it go. Let it go. That problem, that thing that that brother has done, let it go. What that sister has done, let it go. My question is there somebody that have not been offended? Is there somebody that have not offended somebody? There is no one of you here. There is no one of us that have not offended somebody one way or the other. Because you are not a saint. You are not a saint. One way or the other, you offend one. One way or the other, you offend the brother. One way or the other, you offend the sister. And if that person holds you at the same way you are holding another person, how will it look like? How will it look like? This is time for a change. God is calling for a change. I always tell every one of us, the sin that will take many believers to hell is not the sin of adultery and fornication. Most of the sin is this kind of sin. Unforgiveness. 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 We must do away with it. Anger, bitterness, strife. We must do away with it. Glory be to God. For us to be able to make heaven, for us to be sure of heaven, you must do away with all these things. You must do away with anger. You must do away with bitterness. For you, not for the person. So that God will hear you. So that God will settle you. So that God will answer you. Some of our prayers are hindered because of what I'm talking about now. Some of our prayers have not been answered because of what I am talking about now. Because you have refused. You are dead, Chi. I will never forgive this person. I will never let go. But God let go of your own sin. God died for your sake. The blood that was shed for your sake is not enough. If a man can leave heaven and come down to come and share his blood for you, who have you died for? Who have you shed your blood for? That you are angry to the extent that you can never let go. God himself came in human embodiment to come and die for you, to come and wash you, to come and cleanse you, to come and purify you, to draw you closer to yourself, to himself again. And you as a man, you are saying somebody have offended you. You cannot let go and you are holding that person. What of the God that died for you? May the blood of Jesus not be wasted in your sake. May the blood of Jesus that was shed for you not be wasted in your sake. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you must learn how to do away with it. He says, it's a tool. It's a loophole that devil is using to strive Christians. It's a loophole where demons and their agents is using to strive Christianity, to fight against the people of God, to bring down the people of God. Offenses, anger, and bitterness. These are unforgiveness. These are things that we must do away with as a body of Christ, so that God will settle you, so that God will settle you, so that God, not that man, but you, for your own sake, you must let go. You have no right to hold anybody in your heart. You have no right to hold any man or woman in your heart. All you need to do is forgive them and let it go. Forgive them and let it go, so that God will forgive you, so that God will settle you, so that your prayers will be answered as well. Hallelujah to somebody. Glory be to God. Offenses, anger, and bitterness, these are things that we must do away with in our lives. Glory be to God. Offenses, Matthew. Let us go to that Matthew again. Matthew chapter 18. Glory be to God. I'll be reading from the Bible all through today so that we'll get the clear revelation of what we are talking of. That every word we are saying here today is coming straightly from the word of God, from the Bible, so that you can download it in your spirit and begin to walk according to your word, to the word of God. Hallelujah, somebody. Glory be to God. Matthew chapter 18 from verse 33 to 35. The Bible says, glory to God. Hallelujah. From verse 34 to 35. It says, and his Lord was wrought and delivered him to the torment, to the tormentor, till he shall pay all that was due unto him. So likewise shall my heavenly Father also do unto you, if ye have your hearts forgive not everyone of his brother their own trespasses. We remember the story of the man that was the master forgive, he that was owing the master, and they pleaded for him, and the master forgive him, and the master let go, the master forgive him and let cancel the debt. And this same man, when he came out of the place, the palace, and the Bible says he met somebody that was owing him, and he began to drag this person, and he began to tell this person, you must pay my money, you must pay my money, I will put you in prison, I will put you in jail, I will do this one, this one. Somebody, they took him back to the master, and the master said, but all these things thing you have done. He forgive you. Why are you not forgiving why are you not holding the person back? Why are you holding the sin of the person against that person? Why you cannot let go of this person that is owing you? That is how our life is. It can be thrown into prison. The person can be punished. The person can be thrown into prison. That word prison means punishment for that thing that you have done, because somebody died for you. This is just a picture of Jesus and me and you. I see it in that way, that Christ came to pay a price for you. Christ came to pay a price for you. He came to die for me, to cancel our debt, to cancel our sin, to cancel our pains, to take away anything that has been hindering our lives and destinies. And Jesus forgave you and he let it go. And you, somebody has offended you. A brother, a sister like you have offended you. You said no, you will not let go. And tomorrow you want to pray to which God? Who is God that you pray to? God cannot hear you. The prayer of a sinner is like a filthy, is a rag, that your prayer is shit. You know, they near God. Talk less of God, they hear you. God cannot hear you. Talk less of answering you. My brothers and sisters, the time has come, let it go. The time has come, let it go. It doesn't matter what they have done. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. You have no right to hold any man. You have no right to hold any woman. You have no right to hold any sin of anybody against that person. Glory be to God. If Jesus forgive you, you have to forgive the brother. If Christ forgive you, you have to forgive the sister. The one that came and died for you is bigger than you. Why can't you let go of the same thing that a brother has done to you? Some of us, little things. Let me tell you, I was watching a program one day on television. One of our great fathers in the Lord was doing a revival. He imparted some men of God and some women of God. He now called on this man of God after impartation. He said, come and minister, come and pray and cast away. Let God use you to cast away this demon in the body of this man. This man was a pastor. And when the man of God called him out to pray, this man of God had been doing the same thing to other men of God. And he imparted him and he said, pray, cast away this demon in the life of this man. And the man of God began to pray. And the man of God pray. Demon no and now dead. She demon did not move. He was still manifesting and they're rising and foolish, doing nonsense thing to disgrace the man of God. And when the bad prophet saw this thing, the prophet knew. I believe God gave him true revelation, true discerning spirit, that this person, there's something wrong. If I have been imparting people and they are laying hands and manifestation is taking place, what is wrong with this man? And we were made to understand. The man of God not called the man. He said, hey, you stop there. He said, what is going on? He said, look at you, pastor. He said, that is why I cannot cast out the demon. He said, look at you. He said, you have a brother, your own brother, it's not blood. He said, your brother has sinned against you for a very long time. He said to him, now you say, never over your dead body. You cannot forgive your brother. He said, that is your problem. The man of God was short. He was short of words. He could not answer. And the son ran out and the son said, that is true. And the son began to confirm what the prophet was telling the father. Why is it that the man could not manifest? Unforgiveness, it hinders a lot. It blocks so many ways. It blocks your health. It gives you so many things. It blocks your finances. Unforgiveness is something you must do away with. It's a bad seed of damnation, a bad seed of condemnation, a bad seed that can lead a man, a woman to end up in hell. The spirit of unforgiveness, anger, bitterness, it is very bad. I was watching a movie one day on Facebook. I saw this thing on Facebook, and the man, out of anger, I don't know what happened in the house, the man came to throw something from the house. As angry as he was, he fell from up and the man died. Can you see such an anger? My brothers and sisters, this is something you must delete in your heart. From today, you must reject it. It is a spirit. You must pray against it. Every seed of bitterness, every seed of hatred, every seed of that is unforgiveness, is something that you must delete in your heart. You must ask God to take it away from you, because it will not help you. It leads to hell. It leads to hell. It leads to hell. My brothers and sisters, time has come where we read from Habakkuk to understand that until you let go, until you let go of that brother, until you let go of that sister, my brothers and sisters, unforgiveness give room to tomato. It gives you to the tomato. Who is the tomato? To Satan. It gives room for Satan to torment you when you cannot let go. You are holding somebody, a bitter man, a bitter woman. Hey, people that are bitter, they are always bitter. No matter what you do, they are always bitter. God is a seed that dwells in them. And it's something you must do away with today. That is why when you are angry with somebody, even when you see unforgiveness, anger, bitterness cause disease. They cause sickness. They panic, they destroy your own health, your own health. That is why when you don't forgive a man, that is why when you are bitter against a man, against a woman, whenever you, not that person, the person might have let go. The person might not even care. The person might not even remember if he or she has done something wrong to you. You that is holding that person, whenever you see the man pass, you are angry. Whenever you see the woman pass, you are very angry. You are bitter because of that seed of bitterness that is in you. You feel like killing the person. No matter how happy your mood is, the moment you see the offender, no matter you see the person that have offended you, you become bitter inside you. You become so angry inside you. Maybe that person is happy, but who is destroying who? You are destroying yourself. And the more you allow the seed of bitterness to enter you, to work in you, it begins to change the reason. It begins to take the reason away. To transform you into a different body entirely. The seed of bitterness is not a good one. How does it come from? From offenses that you refuse to let go. The more you begin to soak it in, the more you begin to meditate on that offense that person has offended you, the more you begin to meditate on that thing that person has done to you, the more you refuse to let go, the more you become angry and bitter. The more you become angry and bitter, until you let go, you are not free. That is why you must let go today. What that brother have done, let it go. What that sister have done against you, let it go. It is bad, it is not good, but let it go. It is bad, it is not good, but let it go. You don't like it, but let it go. Let it go so that spirit will leave you, so that you will be free in your life, so that you begin to shine again, so that you begin to walk in line with the word of God. Offenses, anger, and bitterness is something that God is telling us today. We must delay them. Unforgiveness. These are loopholes that devil used to channel the children of God to take them to hell. It is a channel for devil to penetrate a man, to penetrate a woman, to channel, to take them to the pit of hell. Unforgiveness, karaboshakata. I pray for somebody today. That spirit of bitterness in you, that spirit of unforgiveness in you, that spirit of hatred in you, I command it be uplifted right now, be uprooted right now, be rooted away, be rooted away, be rooted away, be rooted away in the mighty name of Jesus. That thing that is making you not to let go, that thing that is telling you, oh, leave her, not forgive her, not forgive her, not forgive her, I set it on fire. I release Holy Ghost here to scatter their powers over your life, over your destinies in the mighty name of Jesus. Why am I praying for you? Because it hinders a lot. He cannot let go. You are holding a brother for years, you refuse to let go. You be demon. May God deliver you. May God deliver you. May God deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Sometimes even we brothers and sisters, we the body of Christ, sometimes you say you have forgiven somebody. Somebody will ask me now and say, oh, I have forgiven the person, but I don't want to talk to them again. Yes, that is a different thing. I'm coming there. Don't worry. Some people will say, I don't forgive my tete. You will say you have forgiven somebody and you are still holding that person in your heart. That is not forgiveness. That is not forgiveness. When you forgive, you let it go. When God forgive, it totally blotted out. It is not, he said, I will remember your sin no more. I will not remember it again. Then God said, I will remember your sin no more. Why are you still holding that brother? And you are telling me you don't forgive her, but you know if you forget. Yes, you cannot forget. Why do you know that you are forgiven somebody? How do you know that you are forgiven that brother, that sister? When you remember, it will not hurt you again. Whenever that thing comes, sometimes maybe somebody might do something similar to what the person did before. It might be the same person, it might be another person that will do something similar to what the other person have done before. It can be so painful to you. My brother, because somebody just did something new and you are referring that thing to the what somebody had done against you for a long time ago. Yes, sometimes it happens like that. But how do you know that you are forgiven that person? Sometimes when we talk of stories of somebody that have offended us, it doesn't mean that we are holding it against that person. We are just saying it as in, well, you are not saying it, you are just saying it as in, like, this thing happened in my life, but I let it go. And it's not hurting you. It's not paining you. It has nothing to do with you anymore. You are just giving reference to it just to encourage another person. Not that you are talking about it and you are still bitter inside you. You are talking about it and you are still very angry inside you. My brother, my sister, you never forgive. Work on yourself. Work on yourself. Learn to work on yourself. It is a decision of the hand. You can decide right now that from today, I will not hold anything against anybody again. No matter what the person does. The person might think he's wise. You are foolish. It doesn't matter. The Bible says the foolish things is what God will use to confront the wise. They might think you are foolish to let go, but God says the foolish, he will take the foolish to confront the wise. God said the best things is what he takes to confront the wise. He said the rejected stone shall be the chief cornerstone. He says, blessed are ye when men shall insult you. A sister in the church in Valencia, so many people that knows me, sister, one of our sisters, Sister Peace, she knows me too much. From the church I started with as a choir, as a chorister, as I was coming up in this in different areas of my life, she's there. Pastor Peace Sunday is the one that struggled. She was there. I passed through her inside the church. Hell inside the church as I was coming up as a Christian. I did not hold anything against anybody. I did not confront any brother, any sister. That is one thing I learned in my Christianity. The first thing I learned is to let go. The moment I was baptized with the Holy Ghost, I learned to let go. It doesn't matter what you have done to me. I learned to let go because you not fit take your own, take spoil my own. Your problem not fit cause spoil my own problem because me, I get where I dey go. If you don't have a place you are going, I have a place I am going to. Everybody have different dimension. You have your own mindset of where you are going. And my race, my mind, every race I'm running is a heavenly race. I cannot go to hell because of you. You must understand, if you miss heaven, you will not miss hell. You must choose one that you have to go. Don't let that brother take you to hell. Don't let that sister take you to hell. Be focused. In the choir practice, we have finished practicing. We were having a program in that very day. I'm just giving this to you for you to know that there are things that ties that if you are not careful, you will miss your blessing. If you are not careful, you will miss your blessing. Why did I tell them that all forgiveness is a tool, it's a channel that devil use for condemnation, to condemn a man, for destruction and for condemnation, unforgiveness. If you refuse to let go, it can hinder you so many ways. This sister came to meet me. We have just finished practice. We have a revival. We just finished choir practice on that very day. She came to meet me. The choir master told her something. I just want to just cut it because for time's sake. And something happened that don't even have to do with me. The sister was angry and she allowed devil to challenge through her to face me. I was not the choir mistress. I'm not the choir master. I was just the one conducting the choir as her day. She now said it is me and she turned everything against me. I was surprised. Say, this woman, what's your problem? I see the way this woman was very angry. She was out for problem. I wanted to challenge her. I hear in my spirit, a little child, though, this person is very small, very, very small. She insulted nonsense out of me. I wanted to answer her. As I look at her, the word of God came to me like a music. He said, blessed are ye when men shall insult you, the book of Matthew, and shall persecute you, and shall say all manners of evil against you. He said, firstly, for my name's sake, oh Jesus. He said, rejoice and be exceeding glad, for great persecuted they that were the prophet before you. Eh? When I heard this word in my spirit, I said, glory, hallelujah. I told the choir master, I said, brother, I will go sing. Come, let's sister, you join, no problem. She what? I said, make una forget Corey. Let us go and sing. God sees my heart. That moment, I heard those words. I let go. Everything was blotted out of my mind, in my heart, instantly. I forgave her from inside me, from the depths of my heart. Let us go and sing. Let us go. Choir master said, we are not singing again. Brother Tony, please, I beg. May we go. Forget this thing apart. Let's go. We went. And when we came out on that very day, the message that the man of God that came, the host came to preach, was titled, let it go. Let it go. You see, when I heard that word, let it go, I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. I said, this message is for me. Let it go. I've let go, Lord. I've let go. No matter what has happened, I've let go everything. And when the man of God was doing ministration, when the man of God came to my front, when he was laying, he just saw me, say, you. He said, I can see that this is how you are ready. He just let her take it. That was when I received the gift of prophecy. Instantly, I begin to prophesy. The first time in my life that I received that gift, look at before I came out, I told us unforgiveness is a tool, it's something, it's a channel that devil uses. It's one of the weapons that devil uses to cause confusion, to cause condemnation, to cause problem in the life of Christians, to bring you down. What happened on that very day? What if I didn't let go that sister? And God had prepackaged something for me on that same service. God has something wonderful for me on that same service. What if I didn't let it go? What if I didn't forgive that sister? I would have missed the blessing of God in that very day. God, that blessing would have passed me on that very day. But thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I was so prepared and I let go. I said, this sister cannot hinder me. I said, nobody can hinder me. I was ready and God touched me, strong touch, in that very service. I pray for somebody here today. Any spirit holding you bound, anything telling you not to let go, every spirit tying you back, everything reminding you of the past problem that is hindering you today not to let go, I command that you'll be broken right now in the name of Jesus. I break the yoke out of your life. I command it be completely broken by the power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That is how devil works. Devil would have used that to hinder me that day. Devil would have used that to block me from receiving from God. Devil wants to use that to take me backward. But thank God, God is alive. Thank God, Jesus is alive. Thank God I wouldn't allow devil. I did not let devil. I didn't give chance to devil to distract me. Some of you will say, I don't forgive. And yet you have not forgiven. You say, I forgive. I mean, when the forgiveness doesn't mean forget. Yes, it doesn't mean forget. But why are you still feeling pain? If you have forgiven, why are you still feeling pain? Why are you still feeling hurt? Why is this still paining you? Oh, this is where this man do me, where this woman do me, where this boy or this girl do me, still they pain me. If I anytime remember, you have not forgiven. If you can still remember and it's still giving you pain, you didn't forgive that brother. If you can still remember and you are still hurt, you have not forgiven. God is telling you now, let it go, my brother. God is telling you now, let it go, my sister. I don't know who is wounded here. I don't know who I'll be offended here. I don't know who I've offended you. God is telling you, on that day, God will ask you. He will tell you somebody preach a message like this to you. God will remind you that somebody preaches message to you to always let go. It doesn't matter. Don't hold any man bound. The Christ died for that man. Jesus did not die for you alone. The blood that was shed is for both of you. The blood that was shed is for that man. If Jesus can die for you, if Jesus can shed his blood for you, who have you died for? Who have you shed your blood for? Can you shed your blood for a man? Can you die even for your children? Can you die for your husband or for your wife? But Christ died for you. God himself came and he died for you to wash you, to cleanse you, to purify you, to take away the sin of that brother. And you are holding that brother down. May God have mercy on you. May God have mercy on you. May God have mercy on you in the mighty name of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, we must let go. We must let go. We must let go. It doesn't matter how it looks like. It doesn't matter what you think. It doesn't matter how you see things. Just what matters is what God says. What matters is what God wants. God is telling you today, let's forgive. God is telling you today, let it go. Let us quickly go to the book of Hebrews. Glory be to God. I told us we are going to be reading from the Bible. I want to be bringing them out one by one from the word of God so that we will not be confused, so that it will not look as if we are just acting or we are just doing whatever we want to do here. I want us to see from the word of God itself. Hebrews chapter 12. Glory be to God. Let us quickly go to Hebrews chapter 12. Barakashakatalabayagadash. Father, we bless your holy name. We give you praise. He said, looking diligently, lest any man fall. Glory, glory, glory. Lest any man fall of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up troubles you, and thereby many be defied. Be defied. How can a man be defied? By the spirit of bitterness. That is why God is telling you today. The spirit of bitterness defies a man very fast. The spirit of bitterness defies a woman very fast. God is telling you, let this thing not come out of you. The spirit of bitterness, no matter what happens, it is offenses that bring bitterness. And when you allow that bitterness to soak into you, it destroys. Even bitter leaf is sweet. Bitter leaf not the sweet. Bitter leaf is bitter, no matter it look like. My brothers and sisters, that seed of bitterness, you must delay it today. You must throw it. Don't let it grow in you. Don't let it be seen in you. Don't let it be part of you. No matter what a man does, no matter what a woman does, do to you. Refuse to be bitter. Refuse to be bitter. Delay it from your hand. Let it go today. Let it go today. It's so painful. It's so painful. It's so painful. Some things that people do to you. Brothers, I understand. Mostly your sisters, mostly your close ones. That is why the word of God says, a man's enemies from his household. It is more painful when your brother offends you. It is more painful when your sister offends you. It is more painful when those that you think that you are one offends you, mostly in the body of Christ, in the church. People used to say, in the church, everybody, they'll say inside church, everybody does the quarrel for inside church. They'll say inside church, this one they happen, the other one they happen. The same happen in your family. The same happen in your mother's and your father's house. My brothers and sisters, we offend everybody in different ways. You offend people in different ways. If in your father's house there is a problem between you and your brother, it doesn't mean that it's not your brother anymore. It doesn't mean that that person is not your sister anymore. The same applies to the church. If somebody offends you in the church, it doesn't mean that the person is no more a Christian. It doesn't mean that the person is no more part of you. All you need to do is let it go. All you need to do is let it go. You need to help that brother to come out of that sin. You need to help that sister to come out of that situation. It might not be good. You might not like it. You might not understand it. My brothers and sisters said, looking diligently, lest any man fall. Let any man fall from where we write from. Hebrews 12:15. He said, looking diligently, lest any man fall of grace. Let no man fall of grace. If you fall of grace, the person will be defiled. And when somebody fall of grace, the person will be disgraced. So disgrace is not your portion. You will never be disgraced in the name of Jesus. May you not fall out of grace. If a man fall out of grace, the next is disgrace. And this shall not be your portion. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may God grant you divine grace. May God grant you grace upon grace. For you not to be defiled. For you not to fall out of grace and be disgraced. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, the word of God said, don't fall out of. He said, leave. No man, no one of you should fall out of grace. No one of you should be defiled by the spirit of unforgiveness. Let it go. Let it go. You don't understand it. Let it go. God is speaking to somebody today. He said, let it go. If not for nothing else but the blood that was shed, let it go. Don't hold any man again in your heart. Don't hold any woman again in your heart. If you are holding a man, you are holding a woman in your heart, you are hindering your blessings. You are hindering your success. You are hindering your promotion. You are hindering things that God has designed for you. Let it go. You have no right to hold any man. You have no right to hold any sin against any woman. You have no right. You have no right, my brothers. You have no right, my sister. Matthew 6:14. He said, for if you forgive men their trespasses, he said, your heavenly Father will forgive you your own trespasses. But if you don't forgive, God will not forgive you. No. God will not forgive you. Even if you pray from now to next year, God not he not hear you talk less of forgiving you. No wonder you are praying and God have not been hearing some of you. Even if your pastor pray for you, go and meet bishop, go meet pope, go meet anybody, tell the apostle, tell them to pray for you. God will not hear them because you are holding somebody in your heart. Until you lose that person, until you let that person go, until you free that person, God will not hear you. God will not hear you if you hold somebody in your heart. The Bible says even if you are holding an offering in your hand, go and drop it, go back, go and reconcile, go and settle with that brother, go and settle with that sister before you can bring that gift to him. Don't, because why? God will not accept it. God will not accept it. My brothers and sisters, time has come for change. Time has come for change. As a body of Christ, we need to change. Change the way we do things. Change the way we talk. Change the way we relate with people. We need to change. Learn to let go of anything, no matter what somebody has done against you. Learn to let it go. Learn to let it go. Please share this video. Share the video. God will surely bless you. So many of you have not really shared. Share. Hallelujah. The first time I'm singing share like this, I surprise you because the cash for you, people will not share. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You love God. That is why you are here. May God bless you today. Learn to let go. Learn to let go, my brothers and sisters. Learn to forgive that brother. Learn to forgive that sister. Learn to forgive that man. Learn to forgive that woman. No matter what they have done against you. Learn to let it go. Learn to forgive them so that God will forgive you. Learn to forgive them so that God will let go of whatever you also have done against him. Learn to forgive so that you can be completely free. So that your sin will be completely blotted out. If God forgive and the Bible says God will remember your sin no more, how can you forgive and you are still remembering the sin? How can you forgive and you are still holding it? How can you forgive and you are still saying it? My brothers and sisters, the Bible says offenses must come. It must come in the church. It must come because of offenses. People no longer go to church because of offenses. People stop going to church. I told you before, it is either you are the offender or somebody offends you. You can offend a man can offend you. A man, you can't. It is either you or the other person. Bible say it must come. In the church today, no wonder we see offenses everywhere. People are angry because of offenses. Nobody wants to go to church again. Because this brother did this against me, I will not go to that church again. Because this sister did this against me, I will not go to that church again. Because this person did this against me, excuse me. Hallelujah. Because this person did this thing against me, I will not go to that church again. I will stop going to church. You are not there to serve the brother. You are not there to serve the pastor. You are not there to serve the sister. You are there to serve God that created you, the one that died for you. Because of offenses, you are the one. Sometimes some people will say, I was discussing with somebody a few days ago, we're talking of the ushers in the church. Some people say the ushers, the way they address people. Some people say the way this one address people in the church. And I begin to look at it. I said the problem in the church is not just one side. At times, even the ushers, when an usher tell a member and say, sister, come and sit down here, they will say, no, I don't want to sit here, I want to sit in the back. And because the usher might insist and say, no, sister, try come here, you'll be offended. Some people, the usher that you think that you are, that have offended you, do you know that you have also offended the usher by disobeying the usher, by disrespecting not only the usher, you have disrespected the rules of the church. It is the church that positioned the usher there to direct everybody to sit well for orderliness in the church. And you just enter the church and they are telling you, brother, sit down here. And they are saying, sister, sit down here. You say, no, I don't want to sit down. At this place now, I want to sit down. As if you are the one that brought the chair from your home. And the brother that you said, no, I don't want. How do you want that person to feel like? And you that they are talking to, you will not come out and say, no, mind that they don't want to. Then it's so funny. If you think the brother have offended you, the brother will also say, you two have offended him or her for not sitting where they order you to sit on. Oh, Jesus. By not sitting where they ask you to sit. Glory be to God. Please, Lord, the noise there. Hallelujah. By not doing what they want you to do. My brothers and sisters, time has come for us to let go. It doesn't matter what you think. Let it go. It doesn't matter what they have done against you. Let it go. When your pastor speak against you, when the pastor try to put this in order in the church, you are offended as a member. No, this is not the time no more. Mostly in this part of Europe where we are, I don't think this thing is common in Nigeria or other countries, other parts of the world. In Europe, abroad, it's very common. When you try to talk to a brother, when you try to talk to a sister, try to like correct them. Nobody wants to be corrected. So by the time you try to talk to the brother and say, no, it's not like this, they are offended. Because of offenses, they will stop the church. Forgetting that the other church they will enter, they won't even do double. Before you know it, you have gone around the whole church in the whole Europe. You have gone on the old church in where you are. Everybody have known you from church to church. That cannot change you. What will change you is to change yourself. What will change you is to change yourself. You have to change yourself. You have to learn to let go. You have to learn to forgive. You have to learn to let go. You have to do away with offenses. You have to do away with anger. You have to do away with that spirit of unforgiveness. You have to do away with them. Why? Because it cannot help you. Why? Because you cannot deliver in that place you are going to. Why? Because you cannot deliver in that place you are going to. That is why God is telling you today to work on yourself. To work on yourself. Let it go. Let it go, my brother. Let it go, my sister. Let it go, my brother. Let it go, my sister. Revelation chapter 121. Revelation 121. Revelation chapter 1. Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 1. Glory, 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 glory be to God. No, not Revelation. First John. It's First John. First John chapter 1. First John 1. I'll read from verse 3. First John chapter 1. I'll read from 3. Glory be to God. The book of First John. Let us see what the Bible says in that very place. Of 1 John, let us see what God is trying to reveal to us in the book of 1 John. Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, this is not the time for you to hold your brother. This is not the time for you to hold your sister. You might not like what that brother is doing. You might not like what the sister is doing. Turn it around. Turn it around. Let the devil be put to shame. 1 John chapter 3 from verse 1, from 14 to 15. 1 John 3, 14 to 15. Glory be to God. 3, 14 to 15. He said, whosoever hates his brother, let me bring it here. He said, whosoever that hates his brother, whosoever that hates his brother, I think I'll read from 15, from where do I read from? From 14 to 15 years. He said, we know that we have passed from death unto life because we love the brethren. He that loveth his brother abideth in death. Glory, that loveth not his brother abideth in death. Whosoever hateth his own brother is a murderer. And ye know that no murderer has eternal life abiding in him. No murderer. If you hate your brother, the Bible says you are already a murderer. May you not be a murderer in the name of Jesus. And there is no life in that person that is a murderer already. So why is the Bible telling us this? God is telling you to do away with hate. No need to hate anybody. No need to hate any brother. The brother might be right, the brother might be wrong. But do away with that spirit of hatred. Let no bitterness stay in you. Don't allow anybody to make you to hate your brother. Don't allow, no matter what that brother has done, to make you to hate them. My brothers and sisters, time has come for us to come together again as the body of Christ so that the church will move on. That is why there is problem in the church today. That is why there is division in Christianity today. That is why we are fighting against ourselves today because of what? Bitterness. Because of offenses. Because of bitterness. Because of offenses. There is problem everywhere because we refuse to let go. God is telling you today, if I am new, it doesn't matter. Anybody that I've offended you, I want you to take a good time, look into your life, search yourself and look around you. Anybody you have offended or anybody that have offended you, do away with it. Forgive that person and let it go. Wash it away. Let it leave you alone so that you will be free. So that you will be free. So that you will be free. Don't hold it against anybody. Don't hold any anger, any sin against anybody. If somebody offends you, learn to forgive instantly, even if the person did not say forgive me. Forgive that person for your own good. Forgive that person for your own self. And if the person comes to you again tomorrow for help, if you have, you want to help, help. The only thing, there are some people that when they offense you, there are some offenses that some people will offend, there are some things that somebody will do to you that you may not want to be that very close to that person, but still that person cannot be your enemy. You might not want to be very close, but it doesn't make the person to be your enemy. You don't want to be very close. You don't want to eat with that person again. You don't want to go out with that person again. You don't want too much intimacy between you and that person again. It's okay, but let it go. It doesn't mean that same person come to ask you for something and you are in position to help, you cannot help. You still help the person. That is what will let you know that you have forgiven the person. That is what will let you know that you are not holding anything against any person again. I feel not be your friend again. But if I have something you want, I can give it to you. It means I don't hold anything against you. And by so doing, God will bless you. By so doing, God will heal you. By so doing, God will transform you. By so doing, God will settle you in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us quickly read this Bible verse. The back book of Mark. Mark chapter, glory be to God. Mark chapter 11, I'll read 25. Mark chapter 11, glory to God. Mark 11, 25. Amen. It says, where would it say? And when you stand pray, we have started from there. I want you to get it again. When you start praying, you say, forgive, forgive, forgive. If you have ought any, if you have ought against any, that your Father which is in heaven also will forgive you. And if you do not forgive, you say, you should know that God himself, which is in heaven, will not forgive you. Let us jump to the same Mark 11, 34 to 35. The same Mark chapter 11, 32. Mark 11, 34. I think so. 34. The same Mark 11. Glory be to God. 33. Yes. Mark 11. It says, glory be to God. And they answered and said unto him, We cannot tell. And they answered and said unto Jesus, we ought tell the answering. Jesus answering said unto them, neither do I tell you by the authority that I do this. No, it's not this Bible verse. Glory be to God. What I'm trying to say, let me go there quickly. It doesn't really matter. What I'm trying to say, there was a time the disciples came to meet Jesus. They asked Jesus, how many times do I need to forgive somebody that offends me? How many times if a brother offends me, if a sister offends me, how many times do I need to forgive? And Jesus told them, they say, is this seven times? Do I need to forgive somebody that offends me? Should I forgive seven times? Jesus said, to them, no, 70 times 7 times. If somebody offends you, Jesus told them, forgive 70 times 7 times. It is not one, it is not two. Can somebody offend you 70 times 7 times a day? Nobody can do that. Even the devil himself cannot offend you 70 times 7 times a day. Jesus knows that offenses must come. That is why he told them very clear, forgive them 70 times, as many times they offend you. He said, just let it be going. Just you do, I beg, go. You can't hear that. This is no, I beg, go. Just be pushing it away like that. Just be taking it away like that for your own self, so that God will settle you, for your own self, so that you will be healed. Offenses, anger, bitterness cause sickness and diseases. It causes sickness and diseases. It's an injury to your own health. If you can see the brother that offends you, and bitterness will make you to want to die, no matter how happy you are. If you are a bitter person and you see the person that offends you, the moment the person is passed, even if you have food you want to put in your mouth, the food cannot enter anymore. Why? Because of seed of bitterness. You can't go nowhere because of that seed of bitterness. That is what anger can cause. That is what unforgiveness can cause. You just see a brother, you just see a person, and you don't remember what that person did. I say, no, I bet this will not tire me. I don't feature up again. Who is angry? Who is a loser? Is the one that refused to eat the food that you have been preparing for, the one that you just prepared. That is person that lose. Not the one that offend you that don't care. And some people can pass their anger, they can pass their bitterness to another person. Sometimes when somebody, have you not seen people, you don't have problem with them from Adam, from nowhere. You don't have problem with them, you don't even know them. And you see somebody, because they hate that person with passion, because they have problem with that person, they want to put you in that package. They want you to come and join them in that office. And they begin to throw seeds of bitterness inside your heart. They begin to bring negative things about that brother, about that sister to you, for you to join them, to hate them. My brother, my sister, don't be part of that. Don't be part of it. If you can let that brother see reason why he should love the person, let him see. If you can let that sister see the reason why she should love that person, let them see. Don't be part of anger. Don't be part of hatred. Don't be part of unforgiveness. When the brother refused to let go, you let it go. Let the brother know the reason why you should let go. Not for any other person, but for you. Not for any other person, but for you. So that God will bless you. So that God will heal you. So that God will deliver you. So that God will answer you. So that God will settle you. So that God will transform you, so that everything that God has for you will enter your hand, so that your prayers will not be hindered, so that your prayer will be answered. My brothers and sisters, this is a message that I have for you. It's for you to let go. Do away with all these things. It will not help you. It cannot help you, no matter how it is. If you are holding a brother, you are holding yourself. You are blocking your prayers. Don't pray. That is what I said when I'm saying it again. If you cannot let go, no need to pray. Don't pray, because God cannot hear you. No matter how you cry in prayer, go and forgive before you come and pray. Go and forgive the brother before you come and pray. Go and forgive the sister before you come and pray. If you can't forgive that brother, forget your prayer. It's like a filthy rag before God. God cannot hear you. Talk less of answering you. God cannot hear you. Talk less of settling you. My brothers and sisters, let it go. That is the message I have for you today. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Transform me. You must be transformed from inside as a child of God, as a body of Christ that we are. I told us the body cannot fight against itself. The tongue cannot say, because I am inside the mouth, I'm not part of the body. The eyes cannot say, because I'm not the leg, I'm not part of the body. The hand cannot say, because I'm not the head, I'm not part of the body. We all are one in Christ. We are the body of Christ Jesus. We are bought with a price. We are wonderfully and preciously and specially made in the blood, in the name of Jesus. We are wonderfully made. We are joint heirs with the Son. We are heirs with the Father. We are made like him. He said the way is, that's how we are. God created us in his own image and likeness, so that we will be like him, so that we will walk like him, so that we will unite like him. Jesus gave us a footstep to follow. Christ is our footstep. Jesus is the way that will follow. He is the way that will follow. If the Bible says is the way, the truth, and the life, if it says is the way, we must see Christ as the way. What are the steps of Jesus? That is the way we should follow. We should be like him. Follow Christ in his way. be like Christ, walk like Christ. The Christians were called, the disciples were first called Christians in Antioch. Attitude, character, behavior, transformation. They acted like Christ and they say, wow, these people are like Christ. What do we call them? Christians, Christ-like. Are you a Christ-like? Are you a Christ-like? Let it go, brother. Let it go, sister. Too much of hate, too much of fight, too much of bitterness in the body of Christ. Let it go. That is why even Christian marriage today is war every time, because of the same weapon of anger, unbelievness, unforgiveness, hatred, bitterness. Devil used to enter marriages. Devil used it to enter between a mother and a father. Mother and children, parents and their children. Devil use it to enter community. Devil use it in any ways to enter a place and cause division and cause distraction and cause problem everywhere. But the Bible says that we should let it go. You should let it go. You are too big for Satan to take to hell. You are too big to end in condemnation with the devil, with those that don't even go to church. You are too, you cannot end your life like them. God is speaking to you today. He said there is a call for change. There is a call for change, a call for change, change of heart, change of heart, change of your mind, your mindset, change the way you reason, change the way you do things, a call for divine transformation. Be transformed. That is what Christianity is all about, from the former you to the new you. He said all things are passed away, everything become new. You are a new born in the body of Christ. You are not born with the blood of Jesus. You are bought with a price. Because of this, you are no longer the former you. You are the new you. Let the new you reflect. Let the new you speak. Let the new you act. Let the new you manifest. Let people see the new you, the new nature of Christ is in, that is in you. The old you is the former character. The old you is the former behavior. Before you have anger. Before you have hatred. Before you hate people for no reason. Before you have that seed of bitterness. But now you are in Christ. No matter what happened, you are no more bitter again. Now you are in Christ, you learn to let go. Now that you are in Christ, you don't hold anything against anybody. Now that you are in Christ, you must learn to come back again. My brothers and sisters, that is the problem we have today in our lives as individuals. It is a problem. Even in marriage, it is a problem. Many of us, even we Christians, that is why at times marriages are breaking today. Sometimes it might be the fault of the spouse. It might be the fault of the man. It might be the fault of the woman. Sometimes we hold it. The Bible says that only of the adultery or fornication, whatever, you can separate. But you can still forgive and let it go. All depends on you. You can still forgive and say, okay, I've forgiven you. I don't let anything against you, but I cannot continue. God will not kill you for that. But the most important thing is forgive. Let it go. Let it go. Don't hold nothing against anybody. You have no right to hold anything against a child of God. It will block you. It will block you. It will block you. This is a message that I got, the Spirit of God laid in my heart today to share with you. Let it go. I don't know who I'm speaking to here right now. I don't know who God wants to change. I don't know that brother, that sister that is still holding somebody against somebody. That whenever you remember you are bitter, the time has gone. Let it go. You have no right to be bitter against the person that Jesus shed the blood for. You have no right to be mad. Forgive that person. Let it go. If you cannot draw the person closer again like before, it is not a problem, but let it go. Forgive the man. Forgive the woman. Forgive the brother. Let it go. Don't remember it no more. Jesus said, "We remember your sin no more." Don't go and keep it in one place. And when something similar happens, and I saw you fell through that day, I forgive you. Now, so you still do, and you are saying it, you are angry. You never forgive. You did not forgive. The time has come. Let there be change. A sister in our church, one sister came to our church, one of our revival one day, and God began to reveal in the truth during the ministration area. God revealed that this sister is holding somebody in Nigeria. This sister has been in Europe for years. She is holding somebody in the hand for 18 years. 18 good years since she left Africa. She is holding that person in the hand for 18 good years. Some of our members is here. Some of our members is here. If I can see them, I know I've seen some of them here. I can. Sister Anita. Sister Anita was in that service that very day. She's here. This sister, and if you see this sister, she's the person that always tell you that, oh, na heart, na God, they look. Na heart, na God, they look. Na person heart, na God, they look. Not be appearance, not be. The God, they see my heart. The way my heart be. The way my heart be. The way this sister used to sing with that, my heart, my heart. You would think her heart is as pure as, I don't know. Until that day, God begin to reveal. Look at this sister. The problem she had, things begin to fall apart for her. And God now brought that revelation. And the true ministration, and the sister said, the revelation was she should let go of that person that she had been holding for years. She was quiet. Because you hold somebody in your hand that offend you, because of this, that is why you are like this, that is why this is happening, that is why that is happening, and by revelation, and God begin to minister, speak to her, all these ways. And the sister, she was calm. Before you know it, and the prophecy said, if you don't forgive this sister, you are in trouble. That is why you are like this. Even this sister we are talking of now, she's about to die. She's at the point of death. If once she said my truth, she said, I hear her. They tell me and they call every time. Then they tell me, say, yes, the sister, they're very sick now. I say, okay, wish me you are confirming the prophecy. Yes. Okay. Now the sister wants to die. How do you feel? She said she just like it like that. And you say, God, see your heart. When you have this kind of a heart for your sister to die because she offends you, she have offended you. And by the grace of God, I begin to calm this sister. Sister, I beg, forgive her from your heart. Not for her. Then through the prophecy, begin to tell her that look at what this thing is causing to you. You think we are begging you now to forgive her for her to be free? No. If you forgive her, you will see how your own life will change instantly. This thing, that is holding you bone, all of them will lose you. The moment you free that sister, no, you will be free. She was crying. I never see that kind of thing before. She was crying, saying, I'm not going to forgive her. Lie. Wait till you do me, pay me. 18 years. 18 good years before you left Nigeria. Wait till she do me, pay me. She was crying. I was sister, I beg. I begin to rub her body. Please, let it go. Let it go. From your heart, not because I'm begging you. If you free her now, the sister would come back. She will be well. You also, you'll be restored. When she now saw the influence, the effect of that thing she was doing on her own part, before she now let go, she now say, I forgive her. And you begin to pray for her. That was how she too was free. So when you are holding somebody bound in your hand, you think you are doing that person. My dear, sorry, you are doing yourself. You are not tying the man. You are not tying the woman. You are tying yourself. For you to be free, let it go. Don't let any man use anything to hold you bound. Don't let any woman use anything to hold you down. Don't allow anybody use anything to tie you down, my brothers and sisters. Bitterness in the heart is like murder. It's like killing somebody. Let it go. The time has come. Forgive the brother. Forgive the sister. Forgive your friend. Forgive your husband. Forgive your wife. Forgive your spouse. Forgive everybody that have offended you. Like I told you, somebody will look at itself and say, I've never drank before. I am not an alcoholic. I don't fornicate. I don't steal. I am trying to live right with God. And all these things, you just see yourself having all this quality. Even maybe say you are even still a virgin. You are so pure. You are so holy according to you. But unforgiveness can take you to hell. Undermining all these qualities that you have. Undermining all these things I just mentioned. Unforgiveness can take the same person to hell. My brothers and sisters, it doesn't matter what you think. It doesn't matter how you see it. God is telling you today, let it go. 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 Begin to search your heart now. Begin to look into yourself now. Begin to think within yourself. Look at that. Look for that brother. Look for that sister that you have offended. The one that have offended you, let it go. 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 I was in a church one day in Valencia, and my dad in the Lord was preaching about this same forgiveness. And the message hits my heart to the extent that the moment we close from church, we close around 10 in the night. And from that 10, I went to look for 24 hours pharmacy, shop, 24 hours shop, where I can fill my phone to call the sister that offended me. This sister offended me. And I was so angry at her at that time. And because of this, and when the message began to come, the moment I left the church, I said, I will not sleep tonight until I call the sister to tell her how painful what she did to me was. But I have forgiven her with all my heart. I went and bought the credit. She's in Ghana, I'm a Nigerian. I called the woman in Ghana. She was shocked. She was shocked. First of all, she was dodging my phone. The daughter picked, I said, give your mother. Tell her I want to talk to her. And the mother and I say, I've forgiven you. Everything you did, I let go. Just take it out of your heart. I forgive you. The moment I did that, I was free. Free yourself by forgiving the brother. Free yourself today by forgiving the sister. Not just saying in your mouth, I forgive you. and you are still holding it. Don't forget, if you don't let go, God will not let go of you. If you don't let go, don't pray. No matter how pastors pray for you, you are still in the same situation. No matter the prophet, the bishop, you go and hide to me to pray for you. God will not forgive you until you forgive. He said God will forgive you your trespasses. If you, after you have forgiven another person, their trespass, he said they will God forgive you. If you want God to forgive you, forgive the brother. Let it go. Forgive the sister. Let it go. Time has come for a change in the body of Christ. In the end time, we will discover that things that will take people to hell, it's just this thing we call little sin. Malice, bitterness, hatred, unforgiveness. All these things will cause small sin. Gossip, lying, backbiting. All these things we call little sins. They are the sins that can take people to hell very fast if you are not careful. That is why you must do away with them today. That is why you must not seek yourself in that cloth. That is why you must not remain in that shade of unforgiveness. Don't allow any man to take you to hell. Don't allow any woman to take you to hell. You are not doing bad things. You are not selling drugs. You are not doing fornication. You are not prostituting. You are not no adultery, nothing. But you hate somebody. You have somebody in your heart. That one alone can take a man to hell. That alone can take a woman to hell. Don't forget, if you miss heaven, you cannot miss hell. May you never miss heaven in the name of Jesus. May you never miss heaven in the name of Jesus. May you never miss heaven in the name of Jesus. Don't try to be like people. Try to be yourself. Follow good examples, not bad examples. Follow good examples that will lead you to eternity, not the one that will lead you to hell. Remember, salvation is personal. Don't allow a brother to make you to hate a brother. Don't allow a sister to make you to hate another sister. Be yourself, because on the last day, you will answer the call by yourself. You are not going to answer for me. I will answer for my own. You will answer for your own. That is how it's going to be at the end day. So because of this, don't because of your father, don't because of your sister, don't because of your husband, because of your wife, go and enter her fire. Some people say, because you know they greet my husband, I don't go greet her. Because you know they greet my wife, I don't go greet her. Because he hates my mother hates my father, I go hate her. My brother and sister, who are you to hate a man? Who are you to hate a woman when Christ loves you and he died for you? And you are hate, that alone is wickedness. It's wickedness. Why should you hate a man? Why should you hate a woman? Why should you say, I can never talk to this person again? Why should you even mark somebody as an enemy? Why? You are blocking yourself. You are blocking yourself. Don't pray if you have not forgiven. Don't fast if you have not forgiven. Don't think if you worship, heaven will open for you. Which heaven will open for you? God hear you. I even want to open for you. When you are holding somebody bound, God cannot hear you. No matter how you worship, no matter how you exalt the name of the Lord, you are Alpha and Omega. You know, he's already Alpha and Omega, but he cannot hear you. We worship you. No matter what you sing, don't go there. God cannot hear you. You are wasting your time. That is why God is telling you right now, change. Change your mindset. Last Sunday, we spoke about change. We spoke about change in the body of Christ. We spoke about character development in the body of Christ. Yes, character development in the body of Christ, which is change in the body of Christ. Character development. This is part of the message. Character development. That is why I'm bringing it level to another level. You need to work on yourself. You need to work on yourself. Work on yourself, work on your character, work on your attitude, work on your mind, the way you think, the way you reason things. Work on it, work on it. We are offended because you are not me, I'm not you. We cannot be the same. If I don't do things the way you do things, it doesn't mean that I don't love you, I hate you. So that cannot make you to be offended at me because I don't do things the way you want. It's my level of understanding. Maybe if I understand it the same way you understand it, I will do it the way you want to. But if I don't understand it the way you understand it, and I decide not to do what you want, why should you be offended? Why should you be angry? Why should you be offended? Because I didn't do what you want. Sometimes you go and meet people for encouragement. You take your matters to people just believing that they will encourage you. The same people will encourage you based on their understanding. I can only encourage you based on how I understand. I cannot encourage you above the knowledge that I have concerning what you are telling me. So if I encourage you based on my own knowledge, you don't have to be offended, because it's what I know I give you. If you don't like it, don't be angry, my brother. Don't be angry, my sister. That is what I know. That is why I'm giving it to you like that. That is how life is. You don't like the way the brother speaks to you. It's what he knows. He can't tell you what he or she does not know. So you don't have to be angry because the way the brother spoke to me, because I went to meet him or her for advice, look at what she told me. No, don't be angry. It's what she know. If you are able to make the person to understand you, maybe the person would now say, ah, this is why this brother did this. So don't pick offense and say, ah, if you see the advice, wait, give me. If no, it doesn't work like that. Little things is what make us to be angry, to be offended. Jesus said offense must come. All these things bound to happen. The ability to handle it is what matters. The ability to delay, to do away with it is what matters. How can you handle things like this? If you're, does it mean that if your children offend you, you say they are no more your children? Why? Why is it that if your children offend you, this is just wickedness? It's devil strategy, it's demonic strategy to bring down people of God. If your children offend you, let me just talk of your children now. If your children offend you, will you say, I will kill you, you are no more my child? Or because you offend me, I disown you, I dismother, I disfather, or I disown you, whatever. Can you say because of this, my son or my daughter have offended me now? Some of our children, what they do at times, oh Jesus. But can we not say because of this, oh, because of this, you are no more my child, I hate you, I will not talk to you again? No. You see that even at times you discipline the child, and you are still correcting the child, you are still disciplining the child, you still love the child. No matter how you beat the child, for example, you still love the child. No matter how you castigar, what did I call it? Castigar, Spanish, don't spoil my English. How you discipline, yeah, how do you discipline the child? How you discipline the child? It's still the same thing. You still love the child. After telling the child, kneel down, do like this. After telling the child, stay in the room, don't come out. Be in the room throughout today. Or after telling the child, I will seize your phone. You are not using mobile phone today. Or you are lock your computer. Don't use computer today. After all this punishment or whatever, or discipline you give to the child, don't you still draw them together? When it's time for food, don't you say, come and eat? You still say, come and eat. That is how life is. We must see everybody as one big family. We are one big family in Christ. One big family. We are bound. We are bought by the blood of Jesus. We are one in Christ. There is no division in Christ. Until we begin to see ourselves this way, my brothers and sisters, devil will always laugh at us. May devil not laugh at you in the name of Jesus. Time has come for us to come together again. We have been divided for so long. We have been separated for so long. God is calling us back again in the bond of togetherness, in the bond of agreement, in the bond of unity, in the bond of working in the bond of working together as one. My brothers and sisters, let us come together as one. May God bless his word into your spirit, soul, and body in the name of Jesus. Let us begin to give thanks to God for the message. Say, Father, we thank you. Begin to appreciate him. Begin to celebrate him. Father, we thank you. Jehovah will bless you. We thank you for your word. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor for your word that you have given to us. We exalt you today, for there is no one like you. We thank you. We thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God for this message. Celebrating, magnifying the name of Jesus for this wonderful name that he has given to you today. Say, Father, we thank you. Lord Jesus, we thank you. Holy Ghost, we thank you for your word. We glorify you for your word. We adore you for your word that make us to know that we must do away with bitterness, anger, unforgiveness, my Lord, my God. Father, help us to be bound in unity. Help us to come together again as one. Help us to come together again as one. Help us, O Lord, to do away with the spirit of division in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Begin to appreciate him. Thank him, thank him. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are going to pray to God. You are going to tell God to help you to do away with every spirit of bitterness. Bitterness is a spirit that you must do away with. Say, Father, help me. Every spirit of bitterness in my life, every seed of bitterness in me, Father, Lord, help me to do away with it. Hey, bokoshi kotola brako koshi bakata la baya. Rekeshi kos konto bragadosh legende bosh ikatala krako Koko Likodosha, Epicotala Bayagadesha, Igo do Rakaka, Kodobash Indo, Reke Kuko Riko Koko Shokoto, Ibak and Sabosh, Nebregedush, Ikatala Baya, in the mighty name of Jesus, every seed of bitterness, I break that yoke over your life, I break that yoke over your life, every seed making you to be bitter, every seed of bitterness in you, every spirit of bitterness in you, by the legal blood of Jesus, I cancel it today. I cancel in the mighty name of Jesus. Maraka bos kenderegedos. Ibakutula ikokore ekeke shadada. I break it. Every seed of bitterness. Anything causing you to be bitter. A boss came to brand bosh negedisha. Raka ko rekekeke dados ibola bayagada. I break it in the name of Jesus. By the mega blood of Jesus, I cancel. Every spirit of bitterness. That spirit making you to be bitter in your marriage, making you to be bitter in your home, making you to be bitter in your family, I break it today. In the name of Jesus, I break it today. In the name of Jesus, we are still going to pray against every seed of hatred. See, it's a seed of hatred. You see somebody, you just hate them. You just hate. Pray against it. Hatred is a bad spirit. It's a spirit that you must do away with in your life. Every spirit of hatred, every spirit that will make man just see a man, you hate the person for no reason. You see a woman, you hate that person for no reason. It's a spirit. That is why husband and wife can be in the home. They are so supposed to be happy, but because of hatred, before you know it, they are divided. It's a bad spirit that you must do away with. Begin to break it. Every spirit of hatred, I destroy your power. Every spirit, I break you, you spirit kereboshenda, raka dudu dodo, yeke kuturo kokodos, maskin sobra, le kerebosh indelele, rakuta kutu kutu, in the mighty name of Jesus, ayakakoto, I break you, you spirit of bitterness, you spirit of hatred, I break your yoke in my life, I break your yoke today, in the life of this brother and the life of this sister, I break your yoke, you spirit of hatred, that is causing hatred, in the life of your people, making the men and the women to hate themselves, husband and wife to hate themselves. You are a spirit. I command you, leave them and come back no more. Leave them and come back no more. Leave them and enter them 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 no more. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, leave them and enter them no more. Ebaya katala bayagada. Yege dorobo shikatala baya. Yege derebro yege dosha. Iko doroko tori katori alabaya. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you are going to tell God to restore you. Father, in any way I've missed you, oh God, restore me. Begin to tell God, oh God, my Father, in every way I've missed you, Father, restore me. Baba, restore me. Baba, restore me. Baba, restore me. Begin to pray for restoration. In every way I missed you, God, I declare restoration. My spirit, soul, and body be restored. Father, restore me again. Restore me again. Restore me again. My restorer, restore me. In every way I missed you. Obey the lokondelebosh. He caused Kent Bragados. He kata katara bregados. Restore me. Oh God, my Father. Restore me. Restore me. Restore me. Restore me. Yendelele shatata. Yendelele yagadabosh. Yendelele. Raka kush iboleke tulo koto. Restore me again. Restore me again. Moshe boluku tulo ketos. Ayandololo shendelele. Akatulo boyagada. Restore me. My restorer, restore me again. Oh God, restore me again. Restore me, God, in the place I have missed you. I declare restoration. In the place I've gone astray, I declare restoration. In the name of Jesus, oh God, restore me. Oh, banelekedos indobegedos legedos. Ah, in the name of Jesus, I declare restoration. May God restore you again. May God restore you again. In every way you have missed, God, I declare restoration. In every way you have gone astray, I declare restoration. May God restore you again. May God restore you again. May God restore you again. In every areas of your life where you have been diverted, where you have been diverted, where you have been misled, I declare restoration. Be restored in your spirit. Be restored in your soul. Be restored in your body. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you. Begin to appreciate him. Jehovah will bless you. Jehovah will glorify you. Be magnified forevermore. In the mighty name of Jesus, I celebrate every one of you here today. As many that are feeling us now, I appreciate every one of you. I celebrate you. I celebrate you. I thank God for your lives. As many viewing us today, I welcome you. I welcome you to today's service in the name of Jesus. I welcome you, Apostle Motu Pesi. I welcome you, woman of God. You are blessed. Great woman of God. You are welcome, man. I celebrate you, great apostle of God. I celebrate you, Pastor Joy, my friend. I celebrate you, woman of God. You are blessed. Minister Nancy for life. I celebrate you, my beloved sister. I celebrate you for joining us. God will surely bless you in the name of Jesus. I celebrate you, Sister Anita. God bless you, Anita, for joining. God bless you, Brother Wisdom, best of waiting. God bless you, Brother Wisdom, for joining us. Hallelujah. Sister Tiana, you came very late. Let's come, man. Let's go to church. Hallelujah. You are welcome, Sister Tiana. God bless you for joining us today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I welcome everybody, Brother Tony, Brother Tony. Anthony, I welcome you. Thanks for joining, Brother Godwin Eze. God bless you, Sister Agatha. God bless you, Sister Peace. God bless you for joining us. I celebrate you, Sister Annabelle. God bless you. Thanks for joining us today in the name of Jesus. I celebrate every one of you, all of you, all of you. Even if I didn't call your name, I am very sorry. Maybe I didn't see you here all the same. I celebrate every one of you. May God bless you for joining us. May God uplift you today in the name of Jesus. The reason why you came, I declare divine settlement in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. If you know you have not given your life to God, this is an opportunity for you to say, Father, here I am. I celebrate you, Sister Princess Ojugo. I celebrate you, my beloved sister. God bless you for joining. Sister Tony Joy, God bless you for joining us. I celebrate every one of you today in the name of Jesus. We are going to pray for those that have not really given their life to God. If you know you have not fully surrendered your life to God, this is a call for total repentance, a call for total surrender to God. I pray for you. You are going to say this prayer after me. You are going to say, Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Son of David, my Lord, my God, I know you are the God that died on the cross of Calvary for my sake. I surrender my life to you today. I believe your blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary, it was for my sake. Father, Lord, I pray today, wash me with your blood. Father, cleanse me with your blood. Father, make me whole again by your blood. In the name of Jesus, say, Father, write my name in the book of life, in Jesus' name. If you just say that prayer, you are born again. You are a child of God. God has written your name in the book of life. Continue shining in the light of God. Look for a Bible believing church. Go and serve God. Don't be among those that believe that you can serve God from your house. No. Jesus was always in the synagogue, and the word of God said we should not forsake the assembling of the brethren. My brothers and sisters, look for a living Bible church, a Bible believing church, and begin to join them to serve God, and God will surely bless you in the name of Jesus. I want to pray for those of us here that their spirits have gone down. You are a Christian, you are a child of God, but your spirits have gone down. I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for your children, if you hear me right now. As many that spirits are going down, that they anointing have come down. My Lord, I pray for restoration. The God of restoration, the God that restored Job, but our Father, restore them again. Oh God, restore your children. Restore their spirit, soul, and body. Restore them to serve you. Restore them to worship you. Restore them to stand right. Restore their spiritual and physical life again. I declare total restoration, your spiritual and physical restoration, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Glory be to God Almighty. I am blessed you came. I am glad to be here today. I love every one of you in the name of Jesus. I thank you for tuning in today. Don't forget, same time we are always here, 6 p.m. every Sunday, 6 o'clock, 6 p.m. Nigeria and Europe time. We are always here to pray, to study the word of God together. Hallelujah. Don't forget, tune in, invite your friends to like our page. Hallelujah. And also, don't forget, if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do well. Go there and support your sister, your friend, your daughter, your mother, your everything. Go there and support me by word, subscribing and liking the YouTube channel. Hallelujah. God will surely bless you as you do so. My YouTube channel is on my page. If you go to my Facebook page, you see the link there. Glory be to God. It's just Prophetess Evelyn TV. Just Prophetess Evelyn TV. Go there and subscribe, and God will bless you. Like the page. Hallelujah. Share with your friends, and God will bless you abundantly as you do so in the mighty name of Jesus. I am happy to see every one of you. I am so glad you came. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let us begin to exalt God. Let us thank Him. Let us thank Him. Let us thank Him. Let us thank Him. May His name be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Un besito fuerte. Big kiss. Big kiss. Big kiss. Big kiss. Carabashikos Konto. La da 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 da. It's my new song. We magnify your name. Let us worship Him. Let's magnify. Glorify God because there is no like You. Let's do that. Magnify Your name.
Because you are Yahweh, because you are Yahweh. Posate, Posalepo, no, you are not.
Christ.